friends, Hari Prasad is back with another lecture on soft skills. The topic for this episode is presentation skills enhance chances to win. Let me start message. Rearing children is an art. Be a diplomat for this job. Coming to the topic, the multifaceted job market is opening many opportunities for the effective presenters. Till yesterday, what we discussed? We discussed communication skills required, business communication skills required, knowledge required, bag and baggage of knowledge required, and all that we discussed till yesterday in all the episodes finished so far. In this episode, what we are doing, the topic we are discussing is presentation skills enhance the job prospects. You will win if you are a good presenter. The multifaceted job market is opening many opportunities for the effective presenters. If you are the effective presenter, you will have job opportunities. Okay? In today's world, how effectively one speaks in various contexts matters a lot. In today's world, what is required? How effectively you speak in different contexts. Both technical and non-technical students need to hone presentation skills as they play a vital role throughout their career. Both technical skills, non-technical students. Technical, non-technical, both students, they need to have presentation skills. Okay. So, presentation skills, both technical and non-technical students, they have to hone. Then only they will be successful in life. Even for presentation skills also, if you have good communication skills, then only you will have good presentation skills. Presentation skills include skills of planning, preparing, practicing, and presenting. These are the four aspects in presentation skills: planning, preparing, practicing, and presenting. You need to plan something, then you need to prepare the matter for that, and then need to practice, you need to practice it, practice required, and then presentation. That's the final part in presentation. So all these things you need to do for presentation. So presentation skills are sine qua non in every student. In good presentation, language matches with audience. If your presentation is good, your language should do match with the audience. Comprehend the strengths and weaknesses of the audience. Before facing the actual presentation, comprehend, understand the audience's background, what type of audience they are. Elite audience, mass audience, what type of audience they are. According to that, use your language. The presenter should take care of his voice modulation, pitch, intonation, expression, and tone. If you are the presenter, what you need to watch? You need to see your voice modulation, how it is, your pitch, how it is, high pitch, low pitch, your intonation, where to go up, where to come down, expression, and tone you are using. They are to be very useful for presentation. You need to check them. Language is most effective means of communication. Language, most effective means, most effective method in communication. Means method. In PowerPoint presentation, the presenter should be thorough with the content of the slides. When you are giving PowerPoint presentation, now what I am giving? I am giving PPT, PowerPoint presentation. Okay. So here also in PowerPoint presentation, You must know, you must be thorough with all the slides that are going to come. What is the next slide? What is the next slide? You must be thorough with the slides in the PowerPoint presentation. Clarity of thought, simple, brief and concise sentences are required to yield the good impression of the audience. What is required? Clarity of thought, simple, brief and concise sentences. Then you will have applause from the audience. Humor is the only tool which can instantly bond the speaker with the audience. If the speaker has humor, using anecdotes, jokes, humor, then automatically the speaker gets connected to the audience. The bond is born from the ability of the speaker to make the audience laugh and relax. The speaker has to make the audience laugh, laugh and relax. Then what happens? Audience will be carried with you. Barriers for effective presentation are, what are the barriers? Fear, lack of preparation, emotional imbalance, inattentiveness and poor communication skills. The speaker should overcome all these barriers. When you are the presenter, when you are the speaker, you must overcome all the barriers in presentation. In presentation, what are the barriers you need to overcome? Fear. Lack of preparation. If the preparation is poor, your presentation is bad. Emotional imbalance. Sometimes you go berserk, uncontrollably violent while speaking. That's not good. Emotional imbalance not required. Emotional balance required, not imbalance. Inattentiveness. If you don't have attentiveness on your lecture or on audience, then you will not be sold. You will not be won. So, inattentiveness you need to shun, avoid. Poor communication skills. If your communication skills are poor, then your presentation also will be poor. So, with good presentation skills, you will have good communication skills. With good communication skills, you will have good presentation skills. Presentation is very important. Thematic coherence, good flow, along with appropriate diction to be used by the presenter. If you want to become a presenter, what you have to do? You need to have thematic coherence. Coherence should be thematic coherence. Coherence should be there from the top one to the down one, down one to down one. Thematic coherence should be there in the presentation. Then good flow required. What is required? Good flow required. Then only you can be a good presenter. Now I will give you one message. India is a legend because many religions and isms took birth in this country. Many religions and isms took birth in this country. That is why I call India, my India, is a legend. Coming to the topic, kinesics plays crucial role in presenter. Kinesics means body language. How you are moving your head. Your hand, your body parts. Kinesics is body language. Kinesics plays crucial in presenter. If your body language is not good, the audience get bored. That is why always concentrate on kinesics, means your body language. Appropriate body language provides good support to the presenter. If your body language is appropriate, then you are a good presenter. Audience will be carried with you. They will carry with you. So where is your speaker? Where is your presenter? They will come with you. In the sense, they will come with you means, whenever you are teaching something, then they will come and watch. Waving the hands into air, frowning, biting the jaws, clenching the fists, concentrating and fixing the eyes only on one side, on front side or part of the audience, ignoring others, will pass a negative message in the listeners. What you have to avoid in your presentation? Waving the hands into air. Waving the hands into air, not good. Frowning, not good. Biting the jaws, not good. Clenching the fists, not good. Concentrating and fixing the eyes. Concentrating and fixing the eyes. Your eye contact only one side, front side, not backside people. What it will give you? Negative message to the audience. That means you have to maintain eye contact, you have to fix your eyes, maintain eye contact, not only the front sitters, the back sitters, end sitters, front, between sitters, all audience you need to take care of. Okay? Looking around, moving in between the audience without hesitation, appreciating the right response, creating positive and friendly atmosphere, make the presentations more successful. See, looking around, here, all the audience, you need to look around. Moving in between the audience without hesitation. You need to move between the audience without hesitation. Go to audience, move around without hesitation. So they feel, so the speaker is near us, he may see us, they will have their concentration in listening. Listening they used to resort to. Appreciating the right response. Oh, you gave like this, you said like this. Appreciating then and there in the audience. Creating positive and friendly atmosphere. Create positive and friendly atmosphere when you are presenting something. All these gestures, all these activities make your presentations successful. Displaying good posture tells the audience that presenter knows what he is doing. The presenter should know what he is doing. Displaying good posture. Then the audience understand that presenter is thorough with the subject. He knows what he is going to tell. When you give that impression to the audience, then you are a successful presenter. I'll give you one message now. Any book may kill your individuality. Don't get influenced by it. Any book you read, don't get influenced by it. Okay? It may kill your individuality. Your individuality, at any cost, you need not forego. Okay? Read book, learn, but don't forego your individuality by reading the book. Okay? Coming to the topic, use presentation aids like flip charts, slides, PowerPoint presentations, audio and video clippings for your presentations. For your presentations, what you have to use? Flip charts, slides, PowerPoint presentations. Slides and PowerPoint presentations are almost all the same. The slideshow is the manual one, is not good today. Audio and video clippings for your presentations. When you are presenting, when you are putting audio clip, video clip, then the audience get attracted to you. But word of mouth can't be substituted by technology. Whatever it is, word of mouth, word coming from mouth, word of mouth cannot be substituted, can't be substituted with the technology. However, technology is grown, but word of mouth will not be substituted by any technology. Please make it in mind. Very important point it is. Technology is now, word of mouth since beginning of the human race. Okay. PowerPoint presentation and other presentation aids are secondary and human presentation is primary in any presentation. PowerPoint presentation or any other presentation is secondary, But human presentation is primary, if not now, even after 1000 years also. Not only now, even after 1000 years, human mouth speaking, you know, that cannot be substituted by any technology. PPT can't overtake the main presenter. The PPT, it can't take the main presenter. I am the main presenter here in this scene. So, main presenter is very important, not the PPT. PPT only secondary, main presenter is primary. Try to make it a point. Not today, even after 1000 years, it will be like that only. However, technology grows. A presentation carries the speaker's personality better and allows immediate interaction between all the participants. When my presentation is going on, or when your presentation is going on, anytime you are presenting, that is instant. When I am presenting with audience can put me questions then and there. Response comes then and there. So that is the beauty of the presentation. Personal presentation. Language teachers don't teach students different topics of grammar, syntax and other things directly. Instead, imbibe them into their minds indirectly. Okay? So, language teachers, what they have to do? They have to imbibe the students with grammar, syntax, etc. Not directly, indirectly. That is why today we are using functional grammar, not traditional grammar. One message. Eyes are windows of the soul. Eyes are the windows of the soul. Coming to the topic. Replace lecture-based teaching in languages by activity-based lessons. Lecture-based teaching in language won't do. Activity-based learning required in language. Practice is the only route towards excellence in making presentations. If you practice. Practice is the only route for making good presentations. Before coming to you to give this presentation, this lecture on soft skills, I presented 100 times yesterday. Then I came in front of you. That means for presentation, practice required. Good practice required. Practice 10 hours, delivery 1 hour. Should be like that. In the university or college, form a team with 8 members led by a leader. Then students have to present on the selected topic in the presence of faculty. Form comes some committee. The students will present before them. Then they will judge. They will adjudge how the student is faring. Okay? Then only the presentation skills can be improved in the students. The presentation skills of the students should be improved in the classroom itself, not after joining the job. Outside judges are to be invited for objective and impartial judgment. In that committee, outside judges also required from other colleges, from other companies, they have to come. And for impartial judgment. Okay? The judges have to assess aspects like clarity, content, body language, time management, presentation skills, etc. The judges will concentrate on these things. Presentation skills, clarity and all these things judges will take into consideration while adjudging you and awarding you marks. Team leader collects and organizes thoughts before actual presentation of his team. So, team leader, six students in a team, one leader will be there. So he will collect the actual matter and he prepares and what you have to speak before the judges, and he trains the other students, then they will be ready for the facing the judges. The best presenters should be awarded and appreciated, which boosts their enthusiasm. The best presenters should be awarded. If the presenter is good, presenting nicely, he should be awarded and he should be appreciated. Then only the good presenters will become. You can train good presenters. Message: the more you try to moralize children, the more they become tenacious. The more they become stubborn, tenacious. That is why don't moralize people so much. Not people, children. Especially in 2021. Coming to the topic, group discussion brings out the winner who has edge over others. In group discussion, one student becomes leader, no? So group discussion edges out all others and one becomes the leader in group discussion. That is why group discussions more often should be conducted in the colleges. What colleges are doing till now, not only in India, in the world, teaching. So the teaching won't do today. All these activities are to be there in the classroom. Then there will be minimum number of absentees in the classes. Absentees are minimized by using the activities, by doing the activities, by organizing the activities in the classes, in the colleges. Now understand that the first one is individual presentation to a judges committee and the second one is a discussion in a group in the presence of judges committee. These activities build up the confidence in the speaker that he can talk spontaneously. Encourage the presenters in the classrooms like this. The language teacher should mold the total personality of the presenter, including voice, tone, pitch, accent, clarity, and body language. This is the duty of the language teacher to do in the classroom. Message. Isolation may lead to suicide, so have company always. So isolation, living alone, that may lead you to suicide. That's why always have some company. One girl or one boy, one servant, whoever, some association. People should live in association only, not in isolation. Isolation may lead to suicide. I have seen many people, for example, one teacher, one professor in Andhra University, Dr. Wesley, he committed suicide in his room. So the suicide note says that he is isolated. His wife left him isolated. That is why isolation should not be there. Always live in association, not in isolation. Coming to the point, episode I am going to close. Before closing the episode, I will give you 3 rules for success. Number 1, trust your brain. Number 2, trust yourself. Number 3, trust. Kona Pariti Hari Prasad. You become successful in life. Thank you. Carpe diem.